Good day, my name is Tim Gilhool. I'm one of two command historians for CASCOM in Fort Lee, and today I'd like to orient you to one of the Ordnance Training Support Facility's most important artifacts, the M10 Wolverine Tank Destroyer. So, folks, back in World War II, the Army was actually trying to figure out the best way to get about armored mechanized combat. There was two separate classes of vehicles that came together, the light and medium tanks, such as the Stuart and M4 Sherman, and a whole separate class of vehicles called tank destroyers. The purpose of the tank destroyers was actually to help break the German Blitzkrieg-type tactics. Their specific merit was to seek, strike, and destroy. This vehicle was originally fielded April 1942. It's got a 3-inch or 76.2mm main gun and a crew of 5. The top is actually open here, and they would have additionally an M2 heavy-barreled Modus 50 caliber machine gun up there. So, first saw combat in North Africa, actually some of the initial battles there, Kasserine Pass, went on to Italy, but really found its strength in Europe. So, over the course of the war, other classes of vehicles would actually come about. You'd actually have the Hellcat and other higher classes of tank destroyers out there. And really, on a one-to-one basis or on a combat killing basis, these things were very effective. So one particular unit, the 703rd Tank Destroyer Battalion, that was originally attached to the 3rd Armored Division, they destroyed 10 enemy tanks or armored vehicles for every one that they lost. However, there are some disadvantages. Because you actually have an open top here, it's vulnerable to small arms fire or somebody throwing a potato masher grenade in there. So I have a personal connection with this, or at least my wife does. So my wife's grandfather served as a battalion S3 and HAC commander in that 703rd Tank Destroyer Battalion, fought in the Battle of the Bulge. You know, earlier in our marriage, you know, he would regale us of stories of actually combat and using these. Now, as the war went on, the Army ultimately came to the realization that the best way to kill a tank is another tank. So, as long as you put sufficient armor and a big enough gun on there, they're able to go toe-to-toe. So, as of 1945, after the end of the war, tank destroyers have gone away. But while they were there, they were a key component in our arsenal and helped bring liberty to Europe. Again, my name is Tim Gilhool. I'm one of the historians here at Fort Lee. I hope you enjoyed our talk here about the M10 Wolverine Tank Destroyer. And remember, support starts here.